back out fishing, back at Old Mill, back on Birch. Got the whole of the new side all to myself, so that's bizarre. I had a good walk round, had a look across that far bank in the distance there, along there. Didn't see anything round the old side, had a look round there, came round this side, onto Party Point, see a big fish just bosh out. Come set up, thought I'll just put the rods out, not put the house up, not commit fully. Seen another fish since then, so yeah, our house is now up. I'm staying put, I'm here for 48 hours. Whether I stay in this swim the whole time, I'm not sure, but yeah, it's feeling good. It's proper windy, so filming will be a little bit awkward this trip. It's like 20 mile an hour winds and it just plays havoc with a mic and sounds absolutely horrendous. So yeah, got one rod to where are you, that little island there at 21 wraps. Seeing as no one's here, I've been cheeky and I'm fishing the swim next door. I'm fishing in his water, so I've got two rods there actually at 17 and a half wraps. So yeah, lovely clean area, so hopefully nobody tears up and goes down there and I can keep them rods there for the whole duration. But yeah, we'll see. But it looks absolutely mint, lovely and windy, low pressure. All that say, all this new side to myself, so I'm in with a good shout, and we'll see how we get on. Well, that didn't take long at all. The rod cast to the island that you can see just top right of the shot. That rod let off a couple of beeps, hit into it. What an absolute awesome creature! 29 pound, 5 ounce, mega looking Old Mill mirror carp that just so made up to have caught one. So early in the trip, absolutely buzzing. Was caught on a Saz wafter, one of my favourite baits I've been using this year. I wasn't able to do any live recording of this because the wind was 21 plus mile an hour and it just sounded absolutely horrendous on the mic. So I've had to do a voiceover on this one just to make the footage more bearable. But so happy to get off the mark so early into the trip. Happy days. Absolutely buzzing with that one. It's caught off the island, 21-1 wraps. But yeah, what an absolute stunner. Just put my rump steak on, halfway through cooking that, couple of bleeps, bobbin pulled up tight, could see the rod tip just gliding up like that. Shot out, hit into it. It's just a steady plod at range. In it comes, steady, steady away. Didn't do a lot until it got under the rod tip. It was battering up and down the margins, fighting like mad, and yeah, buzzing. 29 pound 5 ounce, made up. What an absolute belter. Biggest fish I've had for a while anyway, that's for sure. Good 8 weeks, something like that. So yeah, what an absolute stunner. Massively made up, wicked fish. So let's see if we can get any more. Buzzing. There's a few cormorants circling. Just met that out there, look. I've seen four all moseying about, looking for a free feast. Right, at the end of the first day, it's been a really, really good day. I had that cracking fish, over the moon with that one. To catch any fish from birch is always an achievement. It can be a bit of a tough water at times. It can beat you up at times, but yeah, over the moon to have had one. Set my stall out to try and catch one every time I come, and you get the one. Anything beyond that is just a bonus. Happy days. I'm yeah, proper over the moon, still buzzing about that one. So yeah, it's about 9:30. Not gonna do any more filming unless I catch something, and if I don't, guys, I'll catch you in the morning. Well, it's 7 o'clock in the morning. Not had a single bleep last night, absolutely nothing. It's not a liner, absolutely nothing. Been up an hour or so, and just watching the water. Look how flat it is, so fish spotting should be nice and easy, and I've not seen anything. It's been mega quiet. I'm gonna keep watching the water, and if I see anything that I think I should move on, then I'll be packing the house down and making the move. But as it is, if I don't see out, I might as well just stay put. At least the wind's died down a lot today, unlike yesterday with the 21 mile an hour winds. That was terrible, that, but yeah, it's not meant to be half as bad today. Yeah, I can actually film outside, look. What a lovely morning. Not an ounce of wind. There's two of us fishing this new side. We've got a lot of water between two of us, but all this bank here. Two out to that island there, as you already know. And the fish came from that island there at 21 wraps. Look at that. Looks absolutely mega this morning. The old part of the lake down there. I even put the front on the Tempest yesterday because the wind was that bad. Point, this swim I've plotted up in. So we've got a swim there, swim there, and my one there. It's a great, great swim for a social, and they all do cover a good bit. Just seen one. You just see the rings there. Not massive. That's a good sign. Gonna try and keep a bit quieter. But yeah, got a good bit of water there. That's the track around the lake, around to the old side, and that down there is oak. That's right down there in the distance. There's a few on there this weekend. Oh, that's good. Glad I've actually seen some of that. Well, for now I'll be staying put. Yeah, I'm gonna get the kettle on, have a coffee, keep watching the water. I'm super optimistic now. That's my closest spot to it, that rod there on that island, and that shown there, so at least they're in the area, that's the main thing. Second coffee of the morning. chilling out, watching the water, watching and waiting, seeing that one show just to the right, not seeing nothing else. I'll keep watching. It's 8 o'clock. It's certainly easy to spot them when it's nice and flat and calm like that. But at the minute, I think I'm going to stay put. Unless I start seeing them showing long right across that side, right over there, and that would be an option, or in that corner. Keep watching the water, make my decision what I'm going to do at 11 o'clock. Well, just seen another fish show, like really close in. Four rod lengths out from that swim, just on the right there. That's two shows in that same area. I don't want to put a rod on it, I want to stay put, because I've got one there on that island. Two keer bait over me, other two rods. So I sort of bait and wait and let them come to me. I don't like casting about loads, I don't like chucking at showing fish really in here. It's, you start casting about. I think these fish are that switched on, they've seen it all, and you're just better off just sitting on your hands sometimes. And if your rods are close to them, your leads are, rigs are close to them, let them come to you. Don't get me wrong, if I see a shed load showing in a different swim, I would go round and set up there and fish where the fish are. But once I get them out, me rig's out and I'm happy with them, I tend to just sit on my hands really. It seems to work better. The gulls are diving on some of that. Cormorants are back out today. What's going on with the weather? It's got bloody cold this morning. Stick me joggers and hoodie on. Just don't feel like summer today at all. The weather has been bizarre this year, that's for sure.
Well, it looks like staying put certainly paid off. This time it was the middle rod off the baited area with two Kia Saz bottom baits scattered all around it. Shot off with this awesome looking old mill cracking mirror carp. This one weighing 25 pounds, 10 ounce. Another absolute stunning fish. Had to do a voiceover again because the wind has got up and it's just playing havoc with the microphone. But who cares when you're catching awesome fish like this? What a trip this is turning out to be. So happy, so pleased. Happy days.
Thank you, darling. Still buzzing from that fish, and there's still fish about. Just seeing one bosh tight to that island there, which ain't a million miles away from my right hand rod. So I'm gonna sit on my hands for a few more hours, probably till the middle of the afternoon actually, give it a good bit if they're about, and then redo my right left hand rod. No need to do the middle one because that's been done this morning when I had that cracking 25-10. And yeah, it's looking super promising. Wind's getting up again, but it's due to die off a bit tea time-ish, so Yeah, looks absolutely prime for another one. Well, it's half past one. All three rods redone. All in the zone, on the spot. Lad opposite, Ben, he's had a couple of fish from between the two islands there. So, there's definitely fish about. So I'll keep at it. Not going to touch them rods again. They're on the spot, they're on clean area. Might put a bit more bait over the island one there, but apart from that, I'm just going to sit on my hands and wait for the carp to come along. Not seen a lot for the last couple of hours, but the lad straight across there, he moved round there this morning and he's proceeded to have at least six fish. He's just literally put one back and his other rod's gone off. He's had absolutely easy six fish, two over 30. The rest of the stock is around the 15 pound mark, and God knows what size this one is into now. Because he's having so much action and I'm having nothing, I've put another key of bait out over to that island. Use the throwing stick to put about 20 baits to that island. So yeah, just gonna sit on my hands, done the baiting, just gotta wait now. I'm not a million miles away from him, so Ben's just casting to his markers. He just met mine out, and his is just around the back of the island there, so the fish must be close to me spot, at least my right hand rod, that spot, but just don't seem to be getting any takes this afternoon. They're all going to bed, but never mind. Good angling, good effort to move, paid off, moved out of a good swim, where he'd had a 30 odd pounder, and yeah, proceeded to catch another six. So happy days. Conditions look absolutely spot on for it though. Overcast, low pressure, and the carp are certainly feeding over there, that's for sure. Don't know if you can make that out in the distance. Ben's caught pictures. He's had all them fish today and then tops it off with pictures. That's of a 50 odd pound, named after the man himself, Mark Pictures. Oh, wow. There's a good few people around there. He knows a load of lads off Oak, so they've all popped round to join in his moment. Shame I can't zoom in any more than that.
Yeah, all good. It's over, just over 40.
It's because I ain't got that.
Yeah, just let me get me footing up and I'll be here.
Trying to bring it
That is so much easier to manage than anything else, mate. That's a really good idea. Have no fight left after that, getting weeded up and brilliant. 41.5 pound old mill, absolutely stunning, awesome, hard fighting, gorgeous mirror car. Thank you very much, my love. Off you go. Go on.
Well, I'm absolutely buzzing with that. I can't believe it. What a session this is turning out to be. It's just short of 30, and a 41 pound 8 ounce new PB. So that is absolute wicked. That's two fish off the baited area to that island over there, to the small island. Put about 2.5 key of SAS bottom baits, freezer baits, scattered all around the area with a spod, with a catapult, and absolutely gobsmacked, made up. It took me a long time to break the 40 pound mark. I've gone through a lot of fish on here. I'm starting at the bottom and working my way through them, which is definitely the best way to do it for sure. But wow, I'm still out of breath, still buzzing, want a high. I'm gobsmacked, I'm lost for words. It really is, it's awesome. What a fish, what a fight. Started, look, it got the take, screamer, bzzz, hit into it, fish was coming in, I knew it was heavy, knew it was big, it was coming in, and got about 30, 40 foot out, and weeded me up, solid. I couldn't do anything, give it a bit, and it's not budging. So put the rod back down on the pod, clutch that light. After a minute, tick, 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 started pulling away. So I was like, nice one. Lifted the rod back up, back into it. It went straight back into the weed bed. I was like, oh no. So ended up walking right down beyond the next swim. Got a completely different angle on it. I could feel the line grating on something. And then it was still on. And then steady pressure, kept winding, managed to get it through, got it in front of me, and it just did not want to come up. It really did fire hard. I knew it was a big fish. I thought it was a sort of late 30s, probably 35 plus thereabouts, because I see it come up. It's a big fish, but I didn't think it was over 40 pounder. It wasn't particularly long. It was just very deep, as you can see by the pictures. So, wow, what a battle, what a way to happen. Absolutely, oh, so buzzing, so made up. What a session, three fish. It's, what is it, 7 o'clock at night. Still got till about 10:30, I'm gonna reel in tomorrow. So still got till then. There's every chance of one more, but to be honest, I'm not bothered. At all, I'm done. It was great, but wow, what a session. Happy days. Not sure if the fish have actually moved off now from this central area. It's flat calm, not seeing anything there. But in that channel there, seeing a few shows there, one tight into the channel, and in front of this, to that little island there, I've seen a couple of shows there as well. So yeah, it's 12 fish have been had by myself and Ben from between these two islands in the last, well, since yesterday, in about 30 hours, and I think we've pushed them off now. But I've I've had two from that island there, and a PB. So it's a brave man that packs up and moves after catching three fish and a new PB at 41.5. So it's a tough call, but my instincts are telling me they've done the off and they've now moved, or they are in the process of moving round to the old side, round through that channel, through there and into the old part of the lake. So yes, that's what I'm thinking, but I don't know. It's getting a bit too late to pack up and move, but I've just got a feeling I'm done and I ain't getting any more fish. But I think I'm going to stay put. I think I am. So you never know, it might happen. But I just ain't move after catching a PB from out in front of me and out off my island, off my baited spot. I want to keep two rods on it. Two rods on the dance floor doing the do. But yeah, we'll see. There's loads of mozzies, midges. There's been an outbreak, outburst of them. There's shed loads out tonight. So lit the old citronella candle. Give that a blast for a good few hours until I decide to go to sleep. Hopefully it stops me getting bit to death. But yeah, look how epic it looks out there. That looks like a mirror, that lake. It's flat calm. Looks absolutely awesome. Truly does look good. Still not seeing the fish on my spots. Seeing them in that channel there, towards the channel. Convinced they're heading to the new side, but the old side, sorry. But typical, as soon as I start filming anything, I don't see anything to show. But yeah, time will tell if I'm making the right decision and staying put, but we will see. Getting late now, not going to do any more filming tonight unless I actually catch something else. It's been an absolute wicked trip so far. It surely can't get any better than it has, but you never know, while them rods are out there, anything can happen. So if I don't catch anything, guys, I'll get back to you in the morning, hopefully later with a big fat carp. Happy days. It's 7:30 in the morning. Not a single bleep all night. Absolutely nothing. Had a little bit of rain this morning. And I did think, as I said last night, that the fish have moved off, headed over to the channel there, and round the corner to the old side. I've actually just seen one. Right out in front there, so that's promising. I'm here till reeling around 10 o'clock ish. So there's every chance. But some of my instincts were telling me last night that the best thing to have done would have been move. But we'll see. If I don't catch one before I pack up, then we'll never know, but I just feel that all them fish that had been caught between these two islands, especially by Ben, he'd had 9 fish from between there yesterday. That's unheard of on perch. Absolutely unheard of. Best I've ever done is 5 in 48 hours. But to catch 9 in a day, wow. Good angling. What a top angler he is. But not taking anything away from myself, I've had 3, which is pretty good because it can be a tough old water birch. They don't give themselves up easy. And I'm over the moon with what I've caught. I've been averaging 1 or 2 fish every 48 hours this year. Since the new site's been dug out, the fish have really switched on to it. Not the new site, the new site has been dug out. They've really started feeding, and multiple hits can be possible, but I don't think it'll continue like that. It's just something new. Carp are inquisitive and they've been getting on this new side and having a look and having a feed on all these new spots. So yeah, but on my second coffee of the morning, watching the water, seeing one out in front, so it's definitely worth staying put. Have a nice slow pack up this morning, but I've had a bit of rain, like I say, and to leave it a little bit for the bivvy to dry out, but not to worry. What a lovely morning and what an awesome trip it's been. Can't believe I've managed to have all this bank to myself all weekend, apart from about 5 hours when Skip dropped in on Party Point next to me and then moved to the opposite side of the lake next to Ben, where he was catching all them. As soon as he moved, that's when I had the 41. But yeah, there's 5 pegs on this side. There's one tucked behind that corner there as well. And, oh no, there ain't, there's 6, sorry. But yeah, to have all that to myself, Friday, Saturday, and it's now Sunday morning, absolutely awesome. Especially with a stamper fish that's in here. It should be packed every day of the week. I think there's 3 or 4 50s in here now. Ben's had a new late record at 58 pitches. Oh, Jesus. But I'll keep at it, and one day, I'm sure my tactics are right, one day it'll be my turn and I'll join the 50 club. I'm now in the 40 club. Next step is the 50 club. There's a lot of good £40 plus fish in here for me to catch first though, so I'm doing it the right way if you ask me. I ain't turned up and caught the biggest straight away. I've waded through, shared loads of 20s, 30s, loads. The amount of 30 pounders I've had over the last 2 years is, I dread to think, I ain't counted them. I think there's 400 fish in here in total. There's a good lot to go at, but I'm not sure exactly how many I've had, if I'm honest. I've had a lot of £30 plus fish, a hell of a lot. And I've had a good year this year. It's broke me PB twice. About 3 trips ago, I had the 39 pounder. Now 41.8. What a PB that is. Wow. Still buzzing now, as you can tell. No rain forecast at all this morning. And it's raining for the third time. Supposed to be a little bit cloudy and then sunny, but what is going on with the weather at the moment. It doesn't feel like summer. It doesn't feel like we've really had a proper summer to me. It's been cold on a night. It's for the odd few days where it's been 30 odd degrees, and then the vast majority of it, it's just been really cold on an evening, on a night, and had a lot of rain as well. We certainly have in Lincolnshire, that's for sure. It's not looking like I'll get a dry pack up this morning, but never mind. I can cope with that, especially seeing as I've had three cracking fish. And keep the rods out till the very last minute though. Yesterday, me bat, a 25 pound plus was caught at 20 to 9. So I generally think in here, not that it's set in stone or anything, but generally bite time's up to about 10:30, and it usually goes quiet between 10:30 and 5. That's it, sort of when it's playing ball true to form. But yeah, so I always like to try and keep my rods in till about 11 really. Make a slow, steady pack up. Now that sun's trying to break through. Hopefully, give it another hour with no rain, and I'll manage to get all my kit dry. So I won't have to get any of it out when I get home, apart from the retention sling and me landing nets. Give them a wash, rinse off, hang them up, dry them out properly. Always do that. Got to be done for biosecurity and all that. But yeah, it's Sunday today, and I'm coming back next Sunday week today for another 48 hours. It'd be lovely if I can match my fish captures off this trip next week when I'm coming with my pal Benson, but we'll see. Like I always do, set me stall out for one. Anything beyond that is a bonus. What a lovely morning. Got all the gear on the barra, barring the rods, leaving them in for another 10 minutes, and then I'm going to pack away. What a session it's been. So made up. What a trip. It's been absolutely wicked. Not going to do any more filming unless one of them rods rips off at last knock-ins, but yeah, I'm made up. It's been wicked. It really has. I'd like to say thanks to everybody who supported the channel, who's hit that subscribe button, hit likes, drop some comments. You're all legends. I mean, it really has made me day. The channel's growing really nicely. So I'd like to say thank you to everybody who's hit that button. Brilliant. Thank you very much. I'm going to drop a subscribe button there. If you could subscribe to the channel, it'd be greatly appreciated, guys. Tight lines. See you next week. Bye-bye.